Hello again, it's been so long since I filmed a proper video, and now here I am. Really miss this feeling, like talking to myself with the light on my, with light shining on my face. I have a small haul for you today, so let's just get started. I'm gonna kick it off with skincare, haircare and makeup products. When I was in Germany, me and Zeris walked into Lush, and that was the first time for both of us. We were overwhelmed by the smell and just everything. If you went into Lush, you know what I'm talking about. And when I saw the bath bombs, I wanted to buy them so badly, but then I remembered I didn't have a bathtub, so they would be useless. But I walked out of the shop with this face scrub called Angels on Bare Skin. It's with lavender, I think. Yeah, definitely lavender, and it's for dry and sensitive skin. I won't tell you much because the label is in German. The label is completely useless right now. The lady in the shop told me not to use it very often. So I use it like once or twice a week. It makes my skin so soft and I don't feel the dry patches anymore, which I think is a really good sign. So if your skin is like mine, dry and sensitive, check it out. Last Saturday was the day that I finally cut my hair, and I'm really loving this length. I'm thinking about cutting it even shorter, but I'm not gonna be that crazy. I think that would be a big decision to make, to cut it like this. So I just stopped there. I've also told myself, hey Missy, it's time to stop using heat on your hair, and it's been more than 2 weeks since I blow dried or straightened it. I'm really proud of myself for it. I've also paid a visit to a shop that sells like professional hair care, hair styling products, and I've picked up this cream for curly hair, and it's an antifreeze curl defying fluid from Pro Salon Professional. Like, I can't see the difference yet between using it and not using it and just letting my hair dry naturally, but we'll see. I really want to start wearing my hair naturally, even though the curls are really messy and sometimes not looking good. I've also got some hair silk for my ends, just to give them a little life, maybe. Please help me, She Cosmetics. I picked up a new foundation from Astor, and it's the Perfect Day Foundation 24 Hours Plus Perfect Skin Primer. And what can I say about it? It's a great foundation. And when I mean great, I mean really, really great. The coverage is perfect, it stays really long. I bought it for my prom and for my birthday and just stayed on. There was no need for me to worry if my pimples are showing, I need to go to the toilet, cover it. No, because it stays on. Although it's a really thick foundation, and when I first apply it to my skin, I feel like, oh no, it's too dark, it's too thick. But after a few minutes, it blends with like your natural color and it looks really, really good. But it's thick, so it's not your like casual everyday foundation, more like a party, big outings one. I have two concealers, and the first one is the Rimmel Stay Matte Dual Action Concealer, and it's in like a stick. It's not a liquid one, it's a stick one. And why dual action? It's supposed to cover your blemishes and pimples, but also treat them, because there's like this middle part, this green or blue middle part is supposed to like help you treat your blemishes or pimples. And it really works, because I saw like my pimples getting drier and just smaller. So I would really recommend it, but not for your eyes. It doesn't have a brightening effect, so. For your eyes, no. Other face places, yes. The second concealer is a Belle Multi-Mineral Cover Stick. It's also like a stick, not foundation. It's also a stick concealer. Actually, my mom bought this for me, and when she said, hey, I have a concealer for you, I thought, yeah, it's going to be too dark, too dry, like every other concealer that I've ever tried. But I was surprised, because this is the brightest concealer that I've ever used. I have it on right now, actually, and it covers like my pimples, my blemishes really, really well. I also use it under eyes, because this is the brightest concealer that I've ever used. Probably my favorite concealer right now. Spring is finally upon us! And I think it was snowing about a week ago and now it's 13-14 degrees Celsius outside. I love it! And I thought, hey, this is probably the time for a new jacket. So I bought this baby. I found it in Reserved because they are actually having a sale for like model jackets right now. It's just your normal leather jacket, black, nice sleeves, overall nice. And this is how it looks like zipped up. I really like it and it actually fits me like perfectly. Thank you Reserved for making sizes that fit small people. If you remember the jeans that I showed you in my New Year's tag video, well, they're not useful anymore because I ripped them apart in a few places. I was definitely wearing them too often. And I decided, yeah, you definitely need a new pair of jeans now. So I bought these. These are just normal high-waisted black skinny jeans from H&M. They fit really nicely around the waist and the hips, but of course, they're too long for me. So I don't know if I should just cut them or wear them like this. The last thing is my holy grail of this haul, and it's these shoes. When it comes to shoes and clothing, I love eye-catching shoes. I love extraordinary shoes. And these are definitely an ordinary and eye-catching. I'm not sure if they have a name. I know that Doc Martens have something similar in their collection, I think, but these were much, much cheaper, like maybe 10 times cheaper even. They're really heavy and kind of hard. They will be hard to break in and they're not completely comfortable right now, but give me a month, I will get used to them. They're also shiny, they have laces here, a really thick sole. I like them. Whenever I manage to find something like eye-catching and unordinary, it really makes me happy. Like ordinary shoes and clothes and just bland things are not my style. That's all that I have for today. I hope you've enjoyed the video and please give it a thumbs up if you did. And subscribe if you don't mind me rambling on about clothes and pointless stuff. Have a great week and I'll see you very, very soon. Bye!